Hello friends, welcome to Technique. This is Nirmal here, and in this video we're gonna do the detailed review of the new Oppo watch which was launched in India. So Oppo has launched two smartwatches, basically the same watch with two different sizes. We have the 46mm Wi-Fi as well as 41mm Wi-Fi. So both are pretty good priced, starting at 14,999 and also 19,999. Those are the two variants. So these are available right now in India. So we're going to do a detailed review of this new Oppo smartwatch to see how good it performs. So in terms of hardware, it has a 1.91 inches AMOLED display. It is powered by the Snapdragon Wear processor, and it has the Wear OS and 430 mAh battery. It has water resistance up to 50 meter. So it's well equipped and is a purely smartwatch based on Android Wear platform, and you can actually get all the basic functions and a bit more advanced from Oppo. So let's see how good the watch is for the price segment it is being offered. So let's get started. So if this is your first time on this channel, do hit that red subscribe button and also hit the bell icon to get notified of all the videos we publish. So first step, let's have a look at the design and build quality. Now if you look at the design of this smartwatch, you can see that this looks really good, but this is not an original design because you can see that there is resemblance to Apple's watch. And you can also see the square dials, kind of square, and it also has curved edges on either sides. You can see the top and bottom, and even the sides are also curved, which actually gives a good beautiful design. And you can see that the back panel has the heart rate sensor and also the charging port. It's made of ceramic as well as plastic. We have the glass finishing here, and this actually is an AMOLED display. So we'll talk about that in a while. Now you can also see that this has two buttons here. So this is the button to navigate, and this is actually configurable. You can actually configure what kind of action you want for that button. That is also available. And you can also see that the strap is kind of silicone strap, which actually feels quite good. Now it's flexible and it's comfortable as well. Now the mechanism is kind of different. We would have loved to have a regular watch kind of strap, but still nevertheless it does feel quite good. Now the quality of the material is also really good. So that's the design aspect of the watch. Now you can see that this is a curved display, and you can also see this is the 46mm watch, and you also get a silicone watch. Now the overall build quality looks really good. Now design aspect, we still feel it may not be an original design, but still it is kind of really good in terms of design, and build quality is again superb because it does give a premium finish altogether. Now next is the display. So this is one of the really good aspects about the Oppo watch. It has a beautiful display. In fact, this is an AMOLED display. It's a 1.91 inches AMOLED display with 326 pixels per inch, and it's a touch display. You can see that the touch response is extremely nice, and it's a really vibrant and colorful display, and the touch response is also really smooth. It's a crisp display, and the AMOLED panel looks really nice. So that's the display of the Oppo watch, and this is something which is really good. The outdoor visibility is also really good on the Oppo watch. So that's the display aspect, and you can see that the curved display gives a good overall feel altogether, and the bezels are also kept to minimal, and one of the best displays we have seen on an Android Wear smartwatch. Now next, let's talk about the hardware. So this is powered by two processors. It is having the Qualcomm's Wear 3100 processor. 3100 is kind of 2-year-old processor. Even the 4100 is announced, but it's not available on commercial devices. So it is basically running on the Qualcomm 3100 processor. Now it also has an Ambig Micro Apollo 3 processor, which actually is powering the device when it is in battery saver mode. That's one important thing. Now this is kind of unique actually. Now when you're using the device with a full battery on, it is using the Wear OS and the Snapdragon 3100. But when it goes to the battery saver mode, in fact this is a battery saver mode. Now when it is in battery saver mode, it's like basic functionality, only the steps counter and all those things works, but there is no Wear OS. It's a very simple UI to save battery, and at that time it is powered by the Ambig Micro Apollo 3 processor. And Once you charge the device and you exit the power saving mode, it comes back to Wear OS. So that's one unique functionality of this device, and it has 1 GB RAM and 8 GB internal storage. It also has 430 mAh capacity battery, and you get GPS, NFC, heart rate sensor, water resistance up to 50 meters. So that's something which is really good. So we have been testing this 46 mm strap and watch, and we have been quite impressed with what the hardware offered. Now next, let's talk about the software. So this is running on the Android Wear platform. So this has a Wear OS. Now Wear OS is something which Android or rather Google provides, but this is kind of forked version of Wear OS. Now if you swipe from the top, you get these notification toggles. You can see these are really good notification toggles. You can see volume control, airplane mode, brightness, torch is included. Then you can go to settings. So a lot of things are included here. It's very simple and minimalistic notification toggle, but it's very functional as well. Now if you swipe from the right side, you get the widgets. So you can configure these widgets. So these are the widgets which have been available here. You can go here and press, and you can see that you can add multiple widgets or tile. You can see that there are lots of widgets available, so you can basically pick any widget here. So that's how this works. Now coming back to the home screen, if you swipe from the bottom, you get these notifications. So you can see that these are the notifications. You can clear all of them. So just swipe from the bottom, you can see the notifications. And if you swipe from the left side, we'll just show you that. You can see that this is reserved for Google Assistant. So you can see that you can use the Google Assistant here for alarms or reminders, or you can voice any commands here. Now you can also see that one thing what we missed during our hardware, you can see that these are the speakers. So you can even take calls with this. These are the speakers available. When the phone rings, you can actually use the speakers to answer the call, even though they are not loud enough, but you can use these speakers to answer the call. Now pressing this button, the menu button, you can see these icons. So they are neatly arranged. The good thing is that very responsive, and it's a very fluid UI. Oppo's Color OS is or rather a forked Color OS version is running on this, and you get a lot of options. You can see the call, contacts, then you can see the daily activity, you can see the fitness tracker, there is fitness run, fat burn, outdoor walk, outdoor cycling, swimming, these are the options. Then heart rate monitoring, then 5-minute workout is something which is quite useful. Then you also get breathing exercise. This is very useful. These are breathing exercises. You can start the breathing exercise and do a bit of breathing as well. Now there is sleep tracking available, so you can see that sleep tracking is included here. Then you get the weather information. Then other apps include, there is a recorder included. You can just record your voice included. Then we'll just come back once again. Then you can see that Play Store is there. You can install apps from the Play Store. You can send from your App Store and then install it here. You can see that Wear OS app and Watch Faces, Playtime, Get It Done. So a lot of apps are there for this platform. You can install that. Then there is also Google Translate option included, and you can see other options are also included. Reminders, stopwatch, alarms, and if you go to settings, you can see there is a display customization, sound, apps and notification, gestures are supported, hand gestures are there, tilt to wake, touch to wake, wrist gestures are also included. So these are options. Then you get the connectivity, personalization, you can see that there is also other options included. Now if you press and hold the home button, I will just come back here. Now this button can be configured from the settings. So right now this is for the workouts. You can configure whatever option you want. Now if you press and hold, this is a watch face. You can change the watch face. So Oppo provides a lot of watch faces by default. These are the watch faces available. Some of them are configured. We also installed the Facer app. Facer is a very useful app, actually available free, but you can get a lot of watch faces in the Facer. This is another watch face we have installed from Facer. So you can see that these are the watch faces. This is the default watch face. So you can do a bit of customization here as well. Now, as I said before, the fitness options are plenty. You can see that there is a fitness tracker, and you can do swimming, outdoor cycling, breathing, and all those functions are there. And there is also heart rate monitoring, and heart rate sensor is very accurate. It does a really good job. Even the fitness tracking and the GPS functionality works really well. And since it has GPS, you can actually lock your walking and get the right details of your workout. Now you can actually configure this. There is a app for this. Now this is an app which is available from Oppo. You can see that this is a steps counter. You can see this app provides all the basic details. You can sync with the app, and you can see that heart rate monitoring. There is continuous heart rate monitoring available, so you can actually configure them and use this app. And you can see fitness, you can see the GPS, and you can configure whatever you have done here. Now watch faces you can configure, then notifications you can also configure, manage notifications, what all you want, then watch faces, you can see that there are plenty of them available, and you can configure as I said before. Now another good thing about this is that this, since it is Wear OS smartwatch, you can actually configure with the Wear OS app as well, and you can do a bit of customizations there as well. Now in terms of performance, it's very smooth. The UI looks really good, very smooth and functional UI, and the performance is really good. 1 GB RAM means you get all the tasks done really well, and the notification control, you can even accept calls, as I said before, it works really well. And you can also see that this is very responsive UI. We didn't see any major issues here. It's very responsive UI, and the performance overall looks really good. Even with the forked Android version, it works really well. So that's the software and the performance side. Now talking about the battery, it has a 430 mAh capacity battery, and Oppo claims around 36 hours of battery life, but we got around like 24 hours max. That's like one day of usage you get. It's a pretty good battery, in fact. And with the battery saver mode, so we can't really show the battery saver mode now since it is around 70% battery, but in the battery saver mode, it's just the steps and the basic functionality, no Wear OS is included, so it can get you a bit more battery with the battery saver mode on. So that's again really good. So battery isn't bad, you get still get one day of battery. You may have to charge on a daily basis, but still it's pretty good. Now VOOC charging is supported. You can get around 50% of the battery. This is a 7.5 watt VOOC charging, and you can get around 50% of the battery in just around 15 minutes of charging, which is again good. And the complete charging takes slightly less than an hour, which is again really good. So overall the battery performance is quite good on this device, and it may not be stellar like non-Android Wear smartwatches, but here you get a lot of functionality for that one day of battery life. Feels quite good. Now the speaker is also included, which as I said before is kind of okay for voice calls, but then in surrounding which where there is a lot of noise, it may not be easy to take calls. Now you also get the proprietary charging here. This is the proprietary charging, and you have to carry that if you want to charge this smartwatch. So that was the detailed review of the Oppo watch. Now how good is the watch at 19999? So the base variant is like 14999. There is some functionality differences between the base variant and the 46mm variant. So we have the 46mm variant, and this is priced in 19999, and it works really well. A couple of downside, one is again the battery isn't stellar, but we wouldn't complain on the battery front because most of the smartwatches aren't actually having great battery life. Now the design is something which is quite similar, but still most of the Android Wear smartwatches are having a rounded round, and here we have a square kind of unique design in Android Wear segment. It may have resemblance to Apple Watch, but still this is quite good. Now for us the 46mm variant was slightly bigger. We'll just wear it and show you for a minute, because this size might be bigger for few people. At least for us it was slightly bigger, but then it's also slightly on the heavier side, but once you get used to wearing it, it is not that bad. It's quite comfortable even if you wear complete during the entire day. We did not see any sort of issues, and it was really smooth. So overall at price of 19999, we feel that this is one of the really good, or rather excellent Android Wear smartwatch you can buy. If you want to have a Android Wear smartwatch, this is definitely one of the best you can buy in this price segment. So that's the detailed review of the Oppo Watch, the 46mm. We'll share the link in the description of the video. In case you plan to buy this device, you can go ahead and buy this from the link available. So that's the detailed review of the Oppo Watch. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do hit that like button and also hit the subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.